Ahoy, mast top!
Arr, Captain! I be up here, sir, above the fog in the sunlight. It's beautiful, sir.
What's that big noise I just heard?
Oh, that there is a bloomin' great ocean liner, sir.
Where is it?
Over there. I be pointing at, sir. See my arm? Look.
I can't see your arm, you jerk.
Oh, right you are, Captain. Well, sir, in that case, then, she sort of be over there, if you follow my drift light, sir.
Where is there?
Begging your pardon, sir, but she do be closing in fast, sir. Round about over that way, I should say, sir.
Which way?
Oh, no. Oh, Captain, goodbye, sir.
Hi, I'm David. Welcome to the landscape of geometry. You never really notice how important direction is in your life until you find yourself lost. That's where geometry's handy. It helps to keep things straight, you know, line things up. Lines are a good place to start an exploration of geometry. Most of us don't even realize how much the word line has crept into the language. Why, there's linesman, linebacker, lineman, clothesline, line of sight, speaking your lines. Let's talk about lines. To begin with, particularly straight lines give your life direction. Well, let's start with something a little closer to home. Something I had since I was a kid. My arm. Well, I know. Don't think of it as flesh and blood. Think of it as a short, straight line between two points. One here and one there. Short little pieces of line like that are called line segments. And we assume something about line segments that makes them really important to geometry and to everything. We assume we can extend lines. Right, is to make the arrow follow that imaginary line all the way to the target. Well, actions speak louder than words, huh? Straight. What does that mean? What is straightness? We just sort of know what it means, don't we? After all, you can see if something's straight. Well, you can't always trust your eyes, can you? So how do you describe straightness? Well, you know, I'll put another one next to a straight edge. There. Now I know it's straight. Well, as long as the straight edge is straight. But how do I know the straight edge is straight? See, if you don't ask me, I just sort of walk around knowing what straightness is. But if you ask me, I can't describe it. And it's not just me and it's not just you. Geometers have been trying for like thousands of years to describe straightness. And what they finally did about it was they just gave up. Now they just take straightness for granted. Geometry's got a lot of little basic things like that that it has to take for granted. They're called axioms or assumptions. One of my favorite assumptions is they assume that a straight line is the shortest distance between two points. But they can't prove it. Another thing they assume is they assume that you can extend a straight line in both directions. That sounds simple, but assumptions can be really important. Well, for one thing, extending a short piece of line in a direction can help you find direction. Take a pilot on a tanker. He has to know where to point the ship. He uses an imaginary line segment that runs from the center of the bridge to the tip of the bow. Extended, it points the direction that the ship will go. The pilot of this ferry boat can't see the front of his ship. So, in order to steer properly, somebody has to stick a pointer on the front.
When you're rowing a boat, the problem is knowing where you're going, because you have to sit backwards in them to work the oars. Well, you can either keep turning your head around a lot, or you can do what the boat pilot does, but sort of in reverse. If you attach a pointer on the back, then imagine a line from your eyes to the pointer. And then extend that line that goes from your eyes to the pointer to a point on shore,
and keep that line lined up all the time. That's all you have to do. You still won't know where you're going, but at least you get there straight. How far can you point? Gee, about as far as a line can be extended. To the stars. To the ends of the universe. The unknown heavens beyond.
Thou shalt not point.
Okay. It's rude to point. But sometimes pointing can be a matter of life and death. And after all, for hundreds of years, beams of light have been used to warn people of danger. The lighthouse.
Light is concentrated by channeling it in one direction. The beam of light, or ray of light, is a lot like the ray in geometry, a line extending endlessly out from a single point. A point and a direction. But a ship might be anywhere out there, not just along the beam. How do you warn every ship? Rotate the beam. Now the ray is constantly changing direction. The change between any two directions is called an angle. The common endpoint is known as the vertex. Even though the rays shoot way out into space, near the vertex, an angle is formed that we can easily see and measure.
Okay, before you start to measure that angle, let's just decide how accurate you want it to be. Most of us use a really casual method of splitting our angle of vision in two. You have to pick some ray as a starting ray, sort of the prime ray. So I'm going to take the one that shoots off the tip of my nose and call it front. Then, let's see, I'll take everything to one side of it and call it left. And then, well, you guessed it. Everything to the other side of it, I'm going to call right. Yeah, let's see how that system works. Okay. Left. Left a bit. Oh, left a bit more. Just a bit more. Close enough. Left and right are good enough for lots of things, but not for navigation.
For centuries, sailors have used what they call headings. They called their prime ray, that's the one they start with, north. And then they divided the huge angle formed by turning from north all the way around to north again into 32 smaller angles. Modern sailors and geometers need greater accuracy. So we use a system that divides the largest possible angle, the full circle, into 360 equal angles. And each angle measures 1 degree. So 360 angles, 360 degrees. This newfangled system was actually invented thousands of years ago in ancient Babylon.
Why 360 degrees? No one's really sure, but maybe it was to match up with their calendar. It was based on 360 days in the year. Maybe that's because they didn't have Christmas. But if you think about it, 360 is an interesting number. If you divide it by 10, it goes evenly, 36 times. Divide it by 9, it's still even, 40 times. As a matter of fact, there's only one number between 1 and 10 that doesn't divide evenly into 360. And I'm not going to tell you which one. With this standard system, all you need is a simple tool called a protractor to measure angles. And the angles are measured in degrees. Measuring angles can be full of surprises. Angles have angularity, that sort of angle personality.
At what angle does a modern jet airliner take off? Although it looks steep, and when you're on it, it feels steep, it's only 15 degrees. What angle of slope produces the multi-million kilowatt energy from the St. Lawrence River? Well, from Lake Ontario to Quebec City, the average angle is less than 1 degree. What's a 3-car jump angle? A 20-car jump angle? A jackrabbit car? A high heel? An earth shoe? The angle of launch of a football? The angle of the V-shape made by flying geese? What's the average angle of a nose? What angle is your field of view?
What angle can you lean to and not fall? You know that old saying, all done with mirrors? Well, what that really means is all done with angles. Because you can predict the angle through which light bounces, you can manipulate light rays, distort them,
redirect them to odd places, concentrate them.
Light also changes direction when it penetrates glass or air or water. Spear fishermen have to learn how to judge that distorted image of the fish that they see below the surface. Things are not where they seem to be.
Several animals use geometry to overcome the problem of light distortion. Speaking of angles, some goats are good geometers. Their lives depend on knowing the angles. But all these examples are nothing compared to the way the sun rules life on Earth. In fact, we've used the changing angle of the sun's shadow for thousands of years to tell time with sundials. More than that, the angle of sunlight changes as the Earth revolves around the sun. The result is a change in heat falling on the Earth, summer and winter, warm and cold. Swimming and skiing all depend on the angle of sunlight.
No doubt about it. Extend a few lines and play a few angles, right? Geometry can take you a long way towards where you want to go. Ahoy, mast top! Can you see land?
Aye, aye, Captain, sir. That I can, sir. It's the Sunshine Coast, sir. 45 degrees off the starboard bow, sir.
Good, that's right directions now. Good, in degrees. Good, Jim boy.
That's Lad, sir. That's my last name, Lad. Can't you talk to me like a proper sea captain, sir?
All right. Jim, Lad. Them's your proper directions new. In degrees.
Thank
good,
you,
lad.
Sir. Thank you.
Jim, Lad.
All right, Captain.
I can't see the bow.
Well, sir, go forward till you can, sir, you great steaming banana, sir.
You're right. Sharp angular thinking there, lad. Sharp angular thinking. I will.
Oh, no! Oh, Captain, goodbye, sir!